Come on in the room. Come on in the room. Come on in the room. Jesus is my doctor. He writes up all of my prescription. He brings all of my medicine in the room. Come on now. Come on in the room. Listen, I can't sing, but I am feeling this today. Come on in the room. Jesus is my doctor. He writes up all of my prescription. He brings all of my medicine. Blessings, blessings. Hello, everyone. Glad to be on here today. Hello, hello. Thank you for coming on. Say, keep singing. Girl, look here. I know that ain't my expertise. Look. But I am feeling it. I am feeling it. I am feeling it. Jesus is going to heal your issues today. Come on, somebody. Come on, somebody. Jesus is my doctor. He writes up all of my prescription. He brings all of my medicine in the room. Glory be to God. Glory be to God. Listen here. The Lord is going to heal your issue. Glory be to God. He's going to manifest himself as Jehovah Rapha in your life. He said, listen here, the Lord woke me up. I couldn't even go to sleep. He said that he is going to heal. He said he is going to heal. You ain't even, you know, people think because, you know, you're not getting the healing that you want because you don't have that level of faith. But this healing that God is going to perform in your life, he just going to do it just because he is Jehovah Rapha. It ain't about nothing you did. It ain't about what no one prayed. It's because he want to manifest himself as Jehovah Rapha, the Lord that heals. In Matthew 9, 20 and 21, it says, just then a woman had been subject to bleeding for 12 years. She came behind him and she touched the edge of his cloak. My Lord. She touched the edge of his cloak. She said to herself, if I only touch his cloak, I will be healed. Mark 5 and 25 to 29 says this. And a woman was there. She had been subject to bleeding for 12 years. Glory be to God. She had been subject to bleeding for 12 years. She had suffered a great deal under the care of many doctors and had spent all she had. Yet instead of getting better, she got worse. When she heard about Jesus, she came behind him in the crowd and touched his cloak because she thought, if I would only touch the hem of his garment, glory be to God, I will be healed. Immediately her bleeding stopped. My God. Glory be to God. Immediately her bleeding stopped and she was freed from her suffering. Let me tell you something. I know many times, you know, we're going to the doctors and we're spending all this money for tests and medication and all that stuff. And I ain't telling nobody to stop that. But this particular woman who I'm talking about, she exhausted all she had. All the resources that she had, she exhausted all her resources, spending time and time in doctors. You know, it says she suffered a great deal at the hands of the doctors. We have family members and we have friends that are going through chemotherapy and it seems as if it's doing more harm to their body than good. My God, the chemotherapy is so harsh to the body. It's destroying the body. My God. And so when doctors are supposed to help us to get better, it causes us to get worse. Let me tell you something. A couple of years ago, I had a fall. I had a fall and I hurt my hip and I couldn't walk. And so I would go to the doctor for help. Like, listen, you got to do some of this pain stuff. And they would prescribe me medication after medication after medication. And let me tell you something, it was so bad to the point where I had to tell the doctor, no thanks to the medication, sir. Like, no more. I told the doctor, I don't want any more medication. Because the medication that is supposed to heal me or make me feel better was making me feel worse. At this time, I was a new mom to my third son. And when I take the medication, I couldn't function. I couldn't help my baby. It had me messed up in my mind, my stomach, everything was just off. I tell the doctor, I said, listen here, I come, I need medication that can help me ease my pain, and plus I can function. And so this is what the problem that the woman had. She was suffering at the hands of the doctor. She already gone there because she had an issue. And until she was suffering at the hands of the doctor, my God. But she heard about Jesus. She heard about someone who was doing miraculous work. She heard about this man, glory be to God, who had the power to heal. And she only believed because, see, in the book it talk about she was in a crowd. And it was almost impossible for her to get to Jesus himself. So she just figured, like, if I could only touch the hem of his garment, I will be okay. If I could just touch, come on now. You know, the oil drains from the head, glory be to God, straight down to the ground. My God. And I believe that she took, as she stepped out in faith, she touched the oil, come on now, that was flowing on Jesus. She tapped into his virtue. Come on, somebody. So today I want to tell you that you have suffered long enough. You have been through long enough. Now it's time for your healing. It's time for the healing of your heart issue. It's time for the healing of the lungs. It's time for the healing of your reproductive system, my God. It's time for your eyes to be healed. It's time for your ears to be healed. Glory be to God. Some people even suffering with mental illness. It is time for you to be healed. Today is the day that God is going to show himself strong and mighty. He is going to show himself a righteous judge. He's going to demonstrate his grace and his mercy. Glory be to God. And he's going to touch your body and you shall be made whole. My God. See, the thing about diseases and sicknesses, my God, listen, sometimes it's an internal issue, but affects you publicly. You can't go to work. You can't socialize. Sometimes you can't hang out around family and friends because your body is so drained, exhausted. You can't go. You can't interact with your children. Some of you can't even perform for your husband like you need to because your body weak. My God, I'm telling you, this is it's not coming to an end next week. It's not coming to an end next month. It's going to end now. God is going to heal you now. The Lord is already, I said, when I was up praying this morning, I said, God, dispatch the angels to go before me. Even before I deliver the word that you have spoken to me, I said, God, send your word before them that they may heal your people, that they may prepare the way, that they may make the rough path smooth and the crooked path straight in the name of Jesus. I said, Father God, everyone that is supposed to hear this word, I said, God, awaken them up to the sound of my voice. The God that delivers by fire, he is coming to touch your body right now in the name of Jesus. Even fibroids are going to be shrinking, even as you decide in yourself, because I said this, because you're hearing me say this, you're going to think within yourself that I'm going to touch and I'm going to feel to see if it is there. Even that act of faith, God is going to move on your behalf, and you're going to see that they were there last night, but they ain't there right now. Glory be to God. God is going to heal endometriosis issues of the reproductive system that has been causing you not to be able to reproduce. God is healing you right now in the name of Jesus. The angels that are responsible for healing are by your side. If you can imagine Jesus before you, and if you can reach out and touch the hem of his garment, God is going to do it for you even now in the name of Jesus. Some of you are dealing with hurt of the heart. You've been hurt by your husband. You've been hurt by family members. God is going to touch your heart right now in the name of Jesus, that you will be made whole. Glory be to God. God is going to heal you. Just because my God, just because he is Jehovah Rapha and he want to manifest himself in your life. See, many of you know that God is a God that provides. Many of you that God, you know that God fights the battle for you, but you don't know him as Jehovah Rapha. You have seen people heal. You have heard of people heal. Oh God, that don't mean that you know God as healer because you see him do it. That do means you know him as healer because you heard about it done. It is time for you to experience this healing. Even there are times, glory be to God, that you are saying, oh, it ain't gonna happen for me. Because, you know, nothing good happens for me. Like, I've been had it bad. Like, everything has just been going crazy in my life. Lord, this word probably ain't for me. Let me tell you something. Everybody under the sound of my voice, you are going to feel the touch of virtue. You're going to feel the Lord move in your life. You're going to feel either a cold chill come on your body. Or you're going to feel the heat rise from your feet. You're going to feel it overtake your body in the name of Jesus. Some of you, a piece of God is going to come upon your life like never before. When you felt a disrupt in your spirit, because everything around you that is going haywire, God is going to heal your environment in the name of Jesus. Yahweh Rapha, he want to manifest himself. He just decided that this is what he want to do. Some of you ain't even cry out and ask the Lord for healing. You ain't even asked God to heal. You've been asking and you've been praying and asking for God for some other stuff. Lord, I need you to fix this. Lord, I need you to fix that. Lord, I need you to fix my children. Lord, I need you to fix my house. You ain't even asked the Lord to heal your body. You ain't even asked the Lord to heal your heart. You ain't even asked the Lord to heal your children. You ain't even asked God for that. But God is just going to do it just because he is Jehovah Rapha. He korobosaya, not by might, not by power, but by the Spirit of the living God shall you be made whole. Glory be to God. Glory be to God. I even see the Lord healing cataract. Cataracts. God is healing it even now in the name of Jesus. God is healing your eyes right now in the name of Jesus. Some of you ain't even gone to the doctor yet because you are afraid what the diagnosis is going to be. You ain't even gone to the doctor because you can't take it. You can't take what the doctor can tell you. But I'm telling you right now, it's going to be all right. God going to fix it right now. Right now. Not tomorrow. Right now. Wherever it is that you need God to fix, you say, God, I receive the word. I receive your healing. God, use me as an example. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. This is the day that the Lord has made. I will rejoice and be glad in it because he is a faithful God. Oh, Robo Shakarabanesi. Yanana Messiah. Some of you, the Lord is going to heal your spouse. Some of your spouse needs some healing. Some of them, they got some things going on inside their mind and in their hearts. God is going to heal their heart in the mighty name of Jesus. I declare it by the power of the Holy Ghost, by the power and the authority given unto me by Jesus Christ of Nazareth. I decree and I declare that your spouse, your husband, or your wife, they are going to experience healing. Some of your spouse are dealing with issues that have nothing to do with you. Some of them are dealing with past hurt, hurt that they have dealt with as a child, hurt that they have dealt with as a teenager. God is going to heal it right now in the name of Jesus. Past hurt, God is going to heal. God is going to remove the taste of bitterness from their mouth. Some of them can't show love because they don't know what love looks like. But today is the day that God is going to remove their stony hearts and give them a heart of flesh, because he is just good like that. He is just good like that. God ain't going to let you live like this no more, because you have stood the test of time. Glory be to God, you have fought the good fight of faith. Now is your time, glory be to God, to receive Robo Shakaya, healing in your marriage, in the name of Jesus, healing in your broken relationship. It is time now. Jehovah Rapha is in your house. He ain't by your sister house. He ain't by your brother house. He ain't just in the neighborhood, but he is in your house, and he is going to manifest himself. You ain't gonna tell people about how God healed your sister. You ain't gonna tell people how God healed your mother and God healed your daddy. But it's time now that you are going to tell people how God healed you, how God healed your home, how God healed your broken womb, how God restored your house. He can't even shake it in your side. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. God is going to do it. God is going to do it. This ain't something you got to ask the Lord. Lord, I hear the word. Please do it for me. Please do it for me. You ain't got to beg for it. All you got to do is receive it. All you got to do is receive the virtue. God has given it out. All you got to do is stretch out your hand and say, God, I receive. Be it unto me according to your will, O God. I receive it in the name of Jesus. I receive healing for my children. I receive the healing for my husband. I receive healing for my wife. I receive it. I receive it. I receive it. Oh, Rabba Seke Abasaya. See, the woman with the issue of blood, she just thought. It was just a thought. She just thought it. She just thought in her mind that if I just touch him, my God, if I just touch the hem of his garment, then I shall be made whole. I want to speak a healing over your mind. See, your mind so clouded that you can't even think this. You can't even think, God, if I just touch the hem of your garment. See, your mind is so clouded. You can't even begin to cultivate the thoughts necessary in order to manifest the healing. I speak healing to your mind in the name of Jesus. See, the enemy, all he been doing is trying to rob you of your peace. He been trying to rob you. But the Bible declares, when the thief is discovered, he have to pay you sevenfold, even if it costs him his whole house. The thief that is trying to rob you of your sanity, we expose him right now in the name of Jesus. And we decree and we declare that he got to cough it up. He got to spit it out. He got to loose it. He got to release it in the mighty name of Jesus. And he got to give you back sevenfold, even if it costs him his own house. Glory be to God. Who tell you touch what belongs to me? Give it back now in the name of Jesus. Glory be to God. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. 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 Father, we thank you, Lord. We bless you, God. We glorify your name, God. We manifest your glory, O God. In our homes, let your glory be revealed in us and through us, O God. Let us be a living testimony, O God, that your word will become true to all nations, O God. In the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Just receive, just receive, just receive it. It is yours. Just receive it. It is yours. Receive it. Receive it by faith. Receive it by faith. In the mighty name of Jesus. Glory be to God. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Glory be to God. Blessings to each and every one of you. Thank you for coming on the broadcast. Please share with your followers. Please share with your friends. Check out my website, www.therealmarriageministry.com. For those of you who have not checked out my podcast as yet, check out my podcast through whatever outlet that you listen to. My podcast is Empowering Wives. Go on there, check it out. And we also have our podcast, The Real Marriage Ministry. Go there and check it out. Thank you guys for coming on the broadcast. I love you. Please visit my website, www.therealmarriageministry.com. If you want to send me a message through my website. Subscribe to my email. Thank you. Thank you for listening to my podcast. Thank you for downloading. Thank you for share. Wherever you can, leave a review. Please leave a review. And also check out my book, When Wives Fight, Families Win. And also to a fight to win, a battle plan for fighting for your marriage. On all outlets, wherever it is, wherever you buy books, check out my books. Let it be a blessing to your life. Let it be a blessing to someone else. Thank you guys for coming on. I love you. I love you. Yeah.